Alright, listen, we're talking about Inazuma today. Inazuma is coming out real soon. Everybody's excited for it. It's about to make or break Genshin Impact for a lot of players, especially content creators, because content creators have been, you know, just making content on every single thing they can in the game. And once this update comes out, they can make so much more content, and it'll be pretty good for the entire community as well as the content creators themselves, and that includes me, of course. And for me, I'm really excited to do this, to simply explore the map, see what's new, see all the new weapons that are going to be available, the new banners that they're going to have, the new areas to explore, some new game mechanics maybe. And I hope it's gonna be really enjoyable in the next foreseeable future. It's gonna be soon, and I'm really hoping they do a good job. I mean, they did a good job with just the Golden Apple Archipelago, so I'm pretty sure they're going to do a decent job just seeing how this all worked, right? Anyways, hopefully it does end up well. The only thing concerning me is the whole situation with if they're going to remove Inazuma eventually after you finished it. Obviously they want to have Teyvat, the entirety of it, with all the zones together in the game, but them removing the Golden Apple Archipelago is a little concerning to me, because if they do that, they might remove Inazuma, or they might remove Mondstadt or Liyue, to sort of make space for the game. And maybe that's not the situation. Maybe they'll have the entirety of Teyvat in the game. I hope that's the situation, because it should be a full game already. But they want to have mobile be able to play the game, obviously, because mobile is their whole marketplace. So many people spend money through mobile, and you know what, it makes sense to sort of adhere to the mobile their base. However, it's going to be very detrimental to the game if they just continue on without, you know, adding any significant thing permanently. So they really need to keep themselves going with that. So yeah, Inazuma is coming real soon, and I'm really excited. A lot of new characters, especially the Electro Archon that's going to be coming out as well. And Yoimiyan and Sayu and whoever, by whoever I also mean Ayaka as well. But yeah, they're all coming real soon. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. What you expect from Inazuma, what you want from Inazuma. If Inazuma is something you look forward to, I'm pretty sure you are. But what kind of changes you want to see in Genshin Impact? For example, I want to see a change in the Battle Pass. The Battle Pass is pretty good already. It has some good loot, but it's not great for, you know, for like spending money. It's not great. Obviously the rewards you get over time, if you accumulate it, it's really good. But in general, this should be improved, especially with the new stuff that they've added, such as like sanctifying essence. It should just add it in here as well. Alongside these, it should be like level 60 now and have like sanctifying essence with here. It should also add some new furnitures, whatever it may be. But yeah, hopefully they do also do something with that. Anyways, guys, that's gonna be it for today's video. I know it's a short one. I didn't have much planned for today, but thank you guys so much for watching this video. Hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, consider liking the video as well as subscribing to the channel, and see you guys in the next video very soon.